We almost finished our game, but there are some pending things to do. One of them is control when the user has guessed the word. The second one is to introduce a score system, so the user will score 1 point every time he gets a word. And the third one will be to chain the word, the example word that we have, for different random words. So let's start controlling when the user has guessed one word. What is going to happen when the user gets one word? Then he's going to score 1 point and show the next word. For that, we need to know when the user has guessed one word completely. So how do we know? In the same way that we have a variable that is counting every time you fail, we are going to have another variable which is counting every time you guess a letter. And it will start on zero. So every time you guess a letter, we will increase this counter. So when we have checked a letter, when we have introduced the last letter, we need to ask if the guessed letter are equal to the word length. This means that if the word has 4 letters and we have guessed the 4 letters, it's that we have guessed the whole word. So then we have to score 1 point and move to the next screen. It's the same screen but with the new word. So we have to clear the previous word and start the game again. Okay. Let's start clearing the game. So for that I'm going to create a method which is going to set the screen, clear the screen completely. So what do we have on the screen? We have the letter fails. Let's remove that first. We know that it's on distance view. So for the letter fails, we set the text an empty string again. We set the text as nothing. What is the next thing? The counters that we have, the guess letter and the fail counter, both have to be set to zero again because we will be starting with a new word. So we will start from zero. And what else do we need? We need to clear the letters, the guess letter, and set the underscores again. Let's see on the view. The next thing that we have to do is clear this the fail letter, initialize the counters, and the next thing is clear this again because we will have the previous guess word, so we have to set the underscore on the edit text again. So this edit text is in the layout letters. So I'm going to call here the layout letters I'm going to find this view. And for every view inside this container, I'm going to set the text underscore. Remember how to do the for int counter while the condition, so while the I is less than the child count, well, the I is less than the number of child that the layout have inside, then I increase the I. So with this, what I am doing is coming to every text view here. So now I will be the position of them, so I need to instantiate the text view. So text view, current text view will be the job letter get child at I. So because I is going to be changing inside the for, this is going to be changing. So if we set the text to underscore, at the end of the loop we will have changed all the values. Okay. Remember also that when I introduce one letter, I want to remove the previous letter from the edit text. So remember that every time that you press the button, this method introduce letter is going to be called, and the value from the edit text is going to be read and stored here. But once we have the value, we can reset the edit text. So this time, every time we click on the button, the view will be empty again. Before continue, let's check that everything is okay. So let's see what we have done so far. We launch the application and we test something in project. If we insert one letter that is wrong, it will show. If we insert one letter that is okay, it will show as a guest letter. And if we finish the work, this will clear the screen. Okay, so this is fine. The edit text has been clear. The word has been clear. The fail letter has been clear. But the image is not has been set to zero. So that is a problem. And to fix it, when we are clearing the screen, we need to set the image again to zero. So copy this. This is calling the, this is instantiating the image view, and now to the image view we just need to set the first image. Okay, so now let's going to continue on the next lesson.